Respected dear family members, my pranams to you. Very recently in Karnataka state, so many negatives and harassments, problems, strikes, hartals, provocative speeches, and strikes and deaths are taking place in the name of Tipu Sultan. All of a sudden, the Congress government in Karnataka decided to celebrate the birthday of Tipu Sultan, which was not celebrated till then. What was the provocation of all of a sudden celebrating the birthday? Nobody knows. But the Congress thought that when it will be an opportunity like what they could get in Bihar, if Tipu Sultan is coronated again through celebrating his birthday, a big group of Muslims and a part of Hindus will be supporting the Congress. Anybody can celebrate anybody's birthday, these are all left to them. But this has been converted as a government function, and Girish Karnad and other writers said that if Tipu Sultan would have born as a Hindu, he would have got the position much higher than Shivaji the Great or Akbar the Great. He specifically said about Shivaji the Great. And he said that when Girish Karnad said, and some of the progressive so-called historians and writers also said, that Tipu Sultan fought against English people. But they just covered the horrible negatives done by Tipu Sultan. In Kerala we used to say, Tipu Vinde Padayottam. The warriors, the soldiers of Tipu Sultan just massacred thousands of Hindus, crushed thousands of temples, and broke the temple continuously, and converted many temples into mosque, and in fact 20,000 people, Hindus, were fed with beef. Beef, the cows and the bullocks slaughtered in front of them, and the flesh was cooked in front of them, that was pumped into the mouth of the Vedic scholars and the Hindus, and they were forcefully converted into Islam. That happened in Malappuram, the present Malappuram district, to Kozhikode and nearby places. Luckily, the Cochin Maharaja, Travancore Maharaja, came together and never allowed Tipu Sultan to invade into South Kerala. Thus the South Kerala got protected, North Kerala got completely under the feet of Tipu Sultan and his word, and many temples were crushed. Even today you can see the temples got crushed by Tipu Sultan, and the majority of the people who are forced to eat beef requested the Samudri of Calicut to allow them to come back to Hindu Dharma. Unfortunately, some of the Brahmins and the king decided that once you have got converted into Islam and once you have eaten the beef, in Hindu Dharma there is no provision to take them back to Hindu Dharma. So they were forced to continue as Muslims. Luckily, Chamaraja Vadayar of Mysore, where Tipu Sultan did his second art of killing and converting, Vadayar unanimously decided that, without asking anybody's permission, those Muslims who would like to come back to Hindu Dharma, he just forcefully converted Muslims were brought back simply to Hindu Dharma. That is why Mysore did not become another Malappuram district of Kerala. I mean, Muslim thickly populated part of India, or Kerala or Karnataka. That fellow fought against, Tipu Sultan fought against British, and wrote to British people, my ultimate aim is to convert all the Hindus, idol worshippers, into Islam. He might have protected one or two temples, worshipped by one among many wives of Tipu Sultan. And after using that princess or wife sufficiently, that temple also got demolished or crushed. And now Tipu Sultan is getting the white painting that he was a patriot. He fought against the British. He fought against the British to bring South India under his feet, under his control. And just like any other Muslim rulers, ultimate aim was converting Hindus into Islam. That he did. Successfully he did using sports, not using the messages of Quran. Such a heinous, cruel man. His birthday was celebrated in Karnataka with the government expense. Unfortunately, BJP and BHP protested. Some of them died in the protest. But most unfortunately, the BJP and BHP never told anything. Anything what really Tipu Sultan did against Hindu Dharma. This should have been taught to the people. This should have been taught to the people before jumping into the protest and serious destructive marches. Remember that, most important, unless you are educating the people first, this type of protest will create a negative effect seriously and more seriously than positive effect. Nobody knows about Tipu Sultan now. Girish Karnad type of people may be teaching the fraud history to them, and that history the so-called progressives and the Congress will be swallowing, and the BJP and the BHP will be isolated from the mainstream. We can say Satyameva Jayate Nanrata Satyena Bandha Vidato Devayanaha. Finally, the truth will strive, that we can say. But till then, what will happen? Bihar will happen. Till then, what will happen? Delhi will repeat. So, before doing anything, just teach the people what happened. Teach what? In one paragraph or one brochure, teach the people what Tipu Sultan did. Print the millions of copies and distribute. You know, in 2000, when Atal Bihari Vajpayee was ruling India as Prime Minister, Pope came to India, and in Talkatora Stadium, he delivered a lecture in which he said, first millennia, Europe got converted, second millennia, America and African countries got converted, and the third millennia is devoted for converting China, India and Asian countries. When Pope was coming over here, the BJP and VHP protested and they said that when Pope should apologize. What? For what he should apologize? Because many of the Christian missionaries killed many Hindus. Where? When? How? For what purpose? That the BJP and VHP did not tell. You know, present Saint Francis Xavier is the most cruel saint in the history of Christianity. He came to Goa and all the Latin Catholics of India came from this Portuguese missionary whose dead body is preserved in Goa even today. Even today, he killed more than 40,000 Hindus who were reluctant to convert into Christianity. And he just smashed 1,400 old temples and converted them into churches or just smashed out. Every Hindu houses, removing the tulasi, sacred basil, he just put the cross in the tulasi plant post. I will say the flower pot. Instead of tulasi, the cross. And he did the worst. Goa Inquisition is the history. That cruel murderer has been converted into Saint Francis Xavier. Many churches are there in Kerala. Festivals are being celebrated in them. The BJP and VHP did not tell anything to the people. What are the heinous activities done by these type of murderers? Exactly like that. what Tipu Sultan did, that the BHP and the BJP, they are not telling anything to the public. Instead, the protester shouting, screaming, killing, dying, and so on going on. Girish Karnad, as a unique historian, created his own history supporting Tipu. Luckily, I do not know exactly, luckily I think others are not supporting him. And he even went to the last point of telling that Bangalore Kembe Gowda Airport should be named after Tipu Sultan, removing the Kembe Gowda name. Finally, he yesterday afternoon, he apologized for creating a painful experience for the Karnataka people who took it in a different way. But he said exactly Kembe Gowda name should be replaced with the Tipu Sultan Airport. That shows that when in Karnataka, all whatever these false pseudo historian writer Girish Karnad is telling is not being swallowed as such. So remember that before entering into any protest, any hartal, any strike, learn and teach, whether it is about Saint Francis Xavier or Tipu Sultan or Haider Ali or Parsi Raja or Aurangzeb or Akbar, then only do anything. Without the Jnana Yoga, Karma Yoga will be false. And Karma Yoga will be creating negative impact. Finally, it will be resulting in what happened in Delhi and also Bihar. But in Kerala, you can see, no negatives were done. Very seriously positive approach was taken. The result could also be seen among the Hindus in Kerala. When the two parties are dividing, 7 sub-parties, and the Christians and the Muslims standing with the Congress, good result could be produced in Kerala exclusively because the messages were given constructively to the Hindus, and the Hindus could obey that, follow that. This is not what is happening in Karnataka. Protest is good after educating the people. Strike is good after informing the people. You know very specifically that media is always against Hindus. Media is always against Hindus and BJP and BHP. Without knowing that, the electronic media, the mass media, run by the corporate business, and also the print media, they are all against BJP, BHP and the Hindus. And they are supporting the so-called progressives and writers who are denigrating Hindu Dharma. They are supporting the writers who are denigrating Hindu Dharma. And no writer is denigrating the Islam and Christianity. Anything happened to Christianity and Muslim, this media is just taking it as a third world war. Only because VHP and BJP failed in creating a powerful bondage with the media. Before that, they are thinking that Modi is the 11th incarnation of Mahavishnu. He came to protect Hindus and our culture. Remember that Mahavishnu's avatar are 10 numbers over. Modi cannot be one among the avatar of Mahavishnu. And no avatar is being selected through election after 5 years. If an avatar is selected as an avatar through election, remember that avatar will also be a failure. Because Indian people know whom to elect, when to elect. So all the protests and all the negatives nowadays may be creating more negative than positives. So learn about Tipu Sultan and his cruelties and his padayota destruction, and making the Hindus eat beef. And every day when Tipu Sultan was going for the war, he used to cut the neck of a Vedic scholar and used to hang in the Tipu Fort in Palakkad. Palakkad Fort, Tipu Fort, he used to hang a Vedic scholar by cutting the head every day, not once in a day, once in a while, for his success. He might have put a Sri Rama ring given by somebody and might have thrown also. He might have preserved one or two temples for getting the benefit of some of the Hindus. But more than 3,700 temples were smashed, converted into mosques, Hindus were converted, and he wrote to the British rulers, "My ultimate aim is to convert South India into the abode of Muslims. Whomsoever is left, you can convert into Christianity." Remember this. Tipu Sultan was not a patriot. He fought with English people only for converting Hindus into Christianity. And making the ruler, making himself the ruler of South India. That too, not for keeping himself as a ruler, but for converting the Hindus into Christianity. Minimum this should have been spread before starting a strike. Thank you very much. My pranams to you.